Hey guys, welcome to WPH Box. This is Ashish, and today we are finally done with Lumia 520 review. And I wanted to make a video and share it quickly with you guys, like how I felt this device. Now, before we start with, let me say, tell you I had this device from last 5 or 6 days. And I was totally using it for, you know, all my applications, whatever I used to do the Lumia 920. And all applications like feed readers, Twitter, and video tools and everything was there in this phone. So it is almost like what I had in 520. And apart from that, I use it extensively for playing games and everything. So whatever I did was done extensively. That's why I was able to do it in 5 days. So don't take that time frame and think it's very quickly. So let's begin the review. Let's start with display and screen quality. Lumia 520 screen is pretty good. In fact, it has an IPS display, which makes sure that when you touch around the phone and all, there's no problem in that. You can obviously do it nicer than any other phone like Lumia 620 itself. But there's one big problem in this. The screen has a habit of catching dust, and if you use it on your phone, like, you know, and if you sweat a lot, all those fingerprints and, you know, water and moisture will, you know, sit very tightly on this. So you want to keep your phone cleaning up all the day, otherwise your touch experience actually gets spoiled. So that's one thing you should know. Now let's talk about the good part also. The touch screen is quality is good, and the viewing angle of the phone, you know, you can view it from any angle and the color doesn't change. That's one thing really good about the phone. Lumia 620 has better colors when it like true colors, but when you change the angle, it actually used to change the color itself. That doesn't happen. So any from anywhere, if you are viewing the phone, you get to see the same color. So that's about screen display and all. Build quality. Now, since the phone is the cheapest Windows Phone 8 around here, there has to be some compromise done with the phone. Now, good thing is Nokia didn't compromise with the quality that's inside the phone, but they did it for outside the phone. For example, the back case of Lumia 520 is exchangeable, so you can actually take this off, and this is cheap. This is not a good plastic, this is cheap plastic. You can actually, you know, fold it and break it also if you want. Lumia 620 cover was very nice. So this is the exchangeable shell, so if you aren't very happy, you know, with this, you can buy another one. That's one compromise they have done. The other compromise which I see they have done is in the packaging. So packaging, they have changed the quality of the earphones. The earphones really hurt, so I cannot use that for listening music. I'll buy better earphones or use a better headphone. So that's one thing you should know. Apart from that, internally, whatever I see, there is no problem in the quality of the phone. The phone is rock solid. Even the battery is good, and the SIM locator and the SD card insert section, they're all very good quality. There's no problem in that. There's only problem is here. So that's the compromise in the build quality. Overall, the phone build quality is not a problem, but the accessory part, that's kind of compromised here. But to bring down the budget, probably they will have to do it. Let's talk about battery life. I was pretty impressed with the battery life. This time I did specifically that, you know, one day I dedicated completely, instead of doing random tests, one day I dedicated for, you know, where I had 1 hour of gaming, 1 hour of music, and a lot of Twitter, Facebook, and browsing. Everything was done on that day, and the battery lasted. And I had a 3G connection on this, so that lasted for like, you know, 10 hours approximately, 9 hours 35 minutes, and I was low on battery. So that 10% battery was still remaining. So, you know, that kind of battery life, you can take a look. Another day experiment which I did was, I took this in an offline mode and took it on driving. So I was using Nokia offline in airplane mode and used it for 1 hour of destination. Then I had 30 minutes of gameplay, and the phone was 4 hours of idle time. And apart from that, this was Twitter, Facebook, and feed reading and everything what I do regularly. And the phone lasted for like 13 hours some minutes. So you know, the battery life is 1430 mAh if I'm not wrong. It really does well with this phone, even though it has a 4-inch screen, but I think the screen or whatever performance is making a lot of difference here. So battery life, I'm really convinced. So if you want a good phone with a good battery life, this is a good quality phone for that. game performance. This phone really did well in game performance. Like as for 7 Heat, if you have, I've already put on a video for that, find a link. That battery performance, the game performance was very, very nice. The graphics didn't have a problem. But thing is, the developers have to port the game right for the phone so it can work on a 512 MB RAM also. So that's one thing you should know, that the game performance is one. There's one drawback, however, like Lumia 920, the phone gets heated around this section of the phone. Though the heat doesn't affect the game performance, but definitely there is a heating issue in Lumia 520. Okay, now let's talk about camera. One of the things which everybody looks into. And since Lumia 520 doesn't have a flash, a lot of people might think, what is the camera quality? Honestly speaking, I wasn't much impressed with camera quality. I think there is a bug, in fact. Because thing is, when I took it with auto flash, if I take macro mode photograph without you setting up a macro mode, it turns out to be a blur image. And any other mode you select, like if I choose macro mode and then take a photograph, there's quite a difference there. So overall camera is okay, very, very okay. I'm not giving a go that it's a great camera. It's a good camera, but you know, there you will find a problem except for the daylight photograph. The daylight photograph was okay, but if you take a object of an image which is far ahead, like I was in a streamer and I was taking a photograph of Eden Gardens, the object which was really far away was getting blurred. You can actually view it in the camera itself. But if you take it like regular, like one-to-one, or in an even, you take photograph a bit closer, the phone, the image turns out to be very nice. But you need to choose particular modes to take photographs, because the problem is the camera autofocus is constantly. So that may be causing a problem. That's what I feel about it. So that's the camera quality. If I talk about video quality, again the same, it's a camera. So you know, the camera quality is again okay. I would not say it's a great camera. It's okay if you want to take, you know, for a video just for fun. It's well okay, no problem on that. But if you want to take a professional camera, like something with 920 or 720, this is not going to compete. So it's a okay camera with for okay uses. Music quality. Everybody wants to listen to music. The music turns out to be good for this phone. Even the speakers are very good. They are louder than normal phones. But if you turn the volume full on and music is like bass and rock and this, it's not going to, you know, sound good on ears. But if you use earphones, they're going to be done better than what you hear on speakers. So music quality is like okay. If you are a music fanatic, you can go 520. It's a okay phone. You won't be disappointed if you aren't very happy. So the last question of the day, should I buy a Lumia 520? I would say you can buy, but you know, you have to be really very tight on your budget for that. Because if I have 5,000 more to spend, I'll go for Lumia 620 instead of going for 520, even though screen quality is good for Lumia 520 than 620. But you know, the overall quality of the images, video and audio, it goes better with 620. But if you're really tight in your budget and you have 10,000 to spend, this is still a good phone for a very regular users. So if you are, you know, want to give a phone for a starter kind of guys, you know, age group between 18 to 22, or even let's go down, you know, like 15 to 20 kind of guys, if you want to buy a Windows for them, this is a good phone to start with. I would say it's a good phone to have, because you know, if you are a very avid user, use a phone for a lot of stuff, this is not going to work on. But if you're a very regular user, normal user, the first time user, you can go and buy it. So what I will suggest is, if you can spend 5 more extra, go for 620. But if you're really want to a tight on budget and you want to see, you know, what is Windows Phone in it and what are the features inside it, you can go and buy this phone. There's no problem in that. So I will leave it on you, because I don't know whether I should recommend. That's an honest statement. So I will let you choose to buy or not to buy. So that's Lumia 520 from WP Expo. This is Ashish.